Now, I wanted to get into MMA. Always liked playing sports, so I was always pretty much in the shadow of like my older brother, who's always really good at sports. So I felt like I always had to really work hard to get it, to get to where I was, and I always had to try to prove myself to everybody around me, to all of my friends, all my brother's friends, my family. So I don't really like to use the term overachiever, but I always wanted to do more than what I was doing it always. So when I was wrestling, I was all county, but I wanted to be a county champ, and I was never a county champ. And then I wanted to go to college and be an All-American, and then I was I ended up getting hurt. So then I was like, all right, I got to do something else. So I started playing lacrosse, and I got I was four-time All-League in lacrosse, All-Division in lacrosse. I was a academic All-American. Then I was like, I didn't get my goal. I wanted to be an All-American. So I was like, I started doing jiu-jitsu a little bit when I was playing lacrosse. And I was like, I got to start, I got to take it to the next thing. I don't want to stop fighting. I don't want to stop competing. That's what I'd like to do. So I started doing jiu-jitsu. I kept wrestling a little bit. And then next thing I knew, I was doing underground fights in Brooklyn and Queens, and I just fell in love with it. I always liked fighting when I was a kid, but I think I found my calling. So after my wrist injury, I was out for about 9 months. I came back. I got to deal with Strikeforce. So I was just healing up from my wrist injury, but they wanted me to fight earlier than I could. I wasn't cleared yet. So I had to push back the fight. They pushed my fight back to August of 2010, I believe it was. So I'm preparing for my fight in August, and then a couple weeks before the fight, I tear my ACL. I go to come back. I'm still in the contract with Strikeforce, and now Strikeforce is going all different directions. I don't even know where it's going. My manager, I have a really good management company, and he couldn't help me. They told me I was going to fight in July, and then the fight in July got pushed to September. And I was supposed to fight in September, and that fight got canceled. And he's like, you're definitely fighting in November. So I said, all right, so I'm ready for this November fight. So I'm preparing for this November fight, and then the November fight gets canceled. So I call up Lou Neglia from the Ring of Combat, and I said, hey, Lou, it looks like Strikeforce is going down. I don't know what's going on. Can you get me a fight? He said, no problem. He cancels the main event. Lou pulled strings to get me on that card. I go to fight. I'm getting ready. A week before the fight, Hurricane Sandy hits. That fight gets canceled. So I said, you know what? Maybe fighting is just not for me. I won my fight, third round submission. I wasn't completely satisfied with my win, with the way I made a couple of minor mistakes, a little cage corrosion, I guess you like to call it. But on the way home, I guess I did enough, because I got phone calls from a couple of different people. And then my manager calls me and says, hey, I got a contract with you for the World Series of Fighting to fight Josh Bergman. Monday, I get the paperwork, sign it by Tuesday. Posted on Twitter Wednesday. Friday, I get a phone call from my manager again telling me that the World Series of Fighting deal is off. He goes, I got good news and bad news. He said, the World Series of Fighting contract is off. But the good news is, I got you a fight in the UFC. You're fighting April 6th. I was ecstatic. I said, oh, great, this is awesome. I ended up hanging up the phone with him, and I'm like, oh, wait, I don't even know who I'm fighting. And then another 2 weeks, I didn't even look the guy up who I'm fighting, because it doesn't matter to me. I'm not the type of guy who likes to worry about the guy I'm fighting. I want to, I know what I have to do to win, and make them worry about me. We found out a couple months ago that my wife is having a boy. In June, and I have a 3.5-year-old girl who's I can honestly say she's like my best friend. Whenever I'm home, I'm playing with her, and I always wanted a boy, but when, of course, my little girl, I couldn't imagine having anything besides my little girl. When it comes down to it, having a son, everybody wants to have like a little clone. It's like an ego thing. I'll start him with wrestling and see how that goes, because that's, you know, that was my base. I think if he could be a professional baseball player and make a lot more money, I think that's, you know, hopefully by, you know, who knows, if by the time he's my age, maybe MMA is the biggest sport in the world and he gets millions. Long Island is definitely one of the most underrated regions as far as we're fighting. It was always Matt Serra, and which is, you know, Matt Serra is a great fighter. You know, now we have Chris Weidman, who's fighting for the middleweight championship, and Gian Vellante, who's fighting for his UFC debut, and of course, you know, Dennis Bermudez, who's just on fire. He's on a 3-fight win streak. He's possible fight of the year over Matt Grice, Costas Filipov, these guys are, Ally Quinta, these guys are all, you know, top level guys. And within the next year or two, watch, all of us are gonna be, you know, top 10. I can almost guarantee you, between the Belmore kickboxing guys, the Sarah guys, the Long Island MMA guys, this group, and then we're all cross training, we're all training with each other, and, you know, we're all gonna get each other better. And, you know, I'm guaranteeing that these guys, every one of us is gonna be top 10. I'm the UFC's welterweight Ryan LaFlare, and you're watching CompuStrike TV.